In the 1981 Orange Bowl, the Seminoles of Florida State, the Sooners of Oklahoma.
Stockstill, keeping it on the ground, now has a long yardage play. Second down and 11. Over the middle, he goes to his tight end, Childers, and Childers moves the ball.
To go to the wide side, you notice they've got a man in motion. He's trying to get somebody open in his own defense. Oklahoma's playing it man-to-man when they go into a slot. He comes off to Childers, who's been on a little delay pattern, in order to pick him up on the first pass play of a game start.
Third down and 5 now. Here's a flat pass. Oklahoma has it hemmed in, and the Sooners make the play behind the line of scrimmage. And so was the place kicker, Bill Capice. Stark, a decathlete from Minnesota, booms it downfield. The ball is taken by Jay Jimerson inside his 20. He's got it broken for the moment. Jimerson comes up. It's second down and 8 now for Florida State. Steve Benson. Oklahoma's offense on the attack as J.C. Watts rolls wide and gets outside the 40-yard line. Florida State fumbles all season long. And now the ball is to Florida State. Sam Plant runs the ball, gets it down close to the 40.
Defensive play.
The pitch back to Platt. There's another big defensive play by Oklahoma. You see Stockstill firing. He can go deep. Rick Stockstill deep. Here comes the blitz. He runs away from it, but he doesn't run away from the Sooners. And more long assessment against them. Second down and 9. Running with the ball is J.C. Watts. He will pitch it back when it seems like. The Tonight Show starring Johnny Carson following local news on these NBC stations. Right now it's the 1981 Orange Bowl. Stockstill rolls out. He keeps. He's got yardage and plenty of it. He's ahead. Celebration time in Miami for 47 years now. Handoff goes up the middle. Michael Whiting gets the call. Close to it. First down and 10 now. No score on the board, but Florida State with its best position inside the 35. Stockstill takes a look deep. Now he's got a run and can't get out of trouble. I'm an old fan. Let him hear. Second down and 4. Rush midfield. Umpire stands right in there behind the backers. The ball comes at him. Hits back. Running high with the ball is David Overstreet. He's inside the 40 and one of the fastest Sooners, David Overstreet. And a foot films to young backs how to block David Overstreet.
Well, when you see an Oklahoma offense get out around the corner, you notice real good blocking at the point of attack by the back. Bobby Butler, the cornerback, comes over a little late. Mike Bonasor overruns the play a little, trying to pursue.
They knew how to stop the wishbone, but they found they were a step too slow. Oklahoma's so fast. This time, Florida State hems it in. State has missed their first attempt. There's no score on the board. Florida State with the ball first and 10 at their 20. Stockstill, hands up. Second back throw is Ricky Williams. And Williams, not big, 170. The best in the country against scoring. Grades out among the top 3 in every department. Hand off to Stanley Wilson. And this, that's 360 yards a game. They go to the run. With the ball to Stanley Wilson, bounces off one tackle. Excellent
injury. I don't know how serious.
And now on third down and 8, J.C. Watts throws. He gets his tight end, Forrest Ballora. He's got a first down and plenty more yards and a first down.
And don't think J.C. Watts can't throw the ball. Now, Ballora makes a real fine play. It's faking a double team block, slides off it, gets underneath the linebackers. You can see both Jarvis right linebacker.
He is that. The linebackers have been great for Florida State. Kurowski, the other one, 2 years old, a former Arkansas linebacker. Down on one knee. The Sooners haven't been in the end zone yet. Here's J.C. Watts. Pop.
You have two outstanding inside linebackers and two excellent outside defensive ends. You've got a lot of latitude to work with. Kurowski got
the season on offense, including 758 yards rushing against Colorado in one game. Here's a fumble. And Florida State has the ball.
Many people don't recognize is how instrumental he was in creating it. Look at the whole right side of the offensive line goes down on the floor, and the game gets a little lonely out there for a running back with three defenders on his neck.
And they upset Oklahoma, then second rank, 31-7. A throw and a strike. Dennis McKinnon coming. Twice Oklahoma's turned it over on fumbles. Here's the fake. And Stockstill on a naked reverse gets ahead and dives ahead for a first down. Boy, still no score on the board. Stockstill gives off. Ricky Williams busts it, and Ricky Williams takes it all the way. Just called his own number. Got it once, didn't the other time. Now he goes to Ricky Williams. He's in the end zone with a touchdown.
You score first against a team like Oklahoma. How much does it do for the attitude of the players on the sideline?
It'll help us at the halftime.
Lead over Oklahoma. A year ago, the Seminoles were on the board.
Played Stanford.
But Stanford jumped him early and beat him, as did Texas. Now, J.C. Watts trying to... Sits down, everything good. Keelings into the ball nicely. Bang! 53 yards, and Michael Keeling puts
second 14.
There's the pitch back. Running wide with the ball, trying to get free and not get very far as Buster. Bobby Bowden said last year we were a step behind them. We knew what they were going to do, but we couldn't stay with them. Here's a throw. And coming out to get the ball is Forrest Ballora, the tight end, and he's all the way down inside the 40-yard line.
Leasley slipped it in for a touchdown. Here we
on
go.
Fourth and the yard. Look at this. J.C. Watts breaks it. One man to beat the All-American.
Tight end. When they did, they didn't put him out there because they didn't want to run the ball over him. He caved in the whole right side of the line. Gave Watts a hole to run in. You don't see Buster Rhymes in any position to get the football. He couldn't get up in front of him to help.
He will do that. He'll call his own number regularly. Now he pitches back, running wide with the ball and looking for the end zone, and going in is David Overstreet. He makes the reception.
This ball looked like a pickoff from the time it left Stockstill's hands. Somehow it found its receiver. Stands up, throws it just like a pitcher. But you can see from a defensive standpoint, few free safeties get an opportunity.
Here he tried a long field goal attempt. Long enough, it's wide. Oh, they're going to run the ball. Look at this play. Straight ahead. Did they get the first down? They did. What a great
chance this guy was going to go for it on fourth down and three. As a result, it worked.
I assure you, I didn't know it was coming. You see the. Now it's going to be first down for Florida State. Sam Platt turns upfield. Sooners hit him.
Okay, that's one cog out of the Oklahoma offense.
But they got some more left, Bob, and here is one of them, Buster Rhymes. But does he have a problem? But look at the blockers now on the other side. Buster Rhymes weaving his way.
Second and 20.
Second and 20. J.C. Watts has the ball, and Florida State.
Which it looks like they're having. They could get run out of the tub.
That's an 11 previous games. Here's a free ball, and Florida State gets the ball.
See it. It was called second down.
Penalty marker is down at the line of scrimmage as Florida State takes it in. Florida State 10. And we'll be right back. Second down and six for Oklahoma on the opening play in the fourth quarter. J.C. Watts gambles and wins. Almost he can have the big day. He ran it 15 times against Colorado this year and gained 258 yards in that game. Watts throws long. Rhodes is out there. And a lot of people converge on the ball and on Rhodes, who was very doubtful as a performer tonight because of a deep hamstring pull. Quarterback for Oklahoma is down, J.C. Watts.
Later stages, but still, 12 carry ain't bad.
Right there, he lost the handle. We have a fourth fumble and a fourth recovery. He's trying to get a license number. He didn't know what hit him. Here's Stockstill, back inside his 30. Swing pass goes out to Whiting, and Whiting gets ahead inside. Well, they have Florida State held at 10 points.
Look out.
Watts has a problem, and oh, down he goes back. They like to spend New Year's Day, their ideal place. He's hit on the same side of scrimmages. J.C. Watson, here's a bad snap, and into the end zone. This will go for a Florida State touchdown. Jerry Butler losing a high snap. And Oklahoma losing the tie in the game as Florida State has taken a 17-10 lead. Bobby Butler sees a loose football, a defensive play. This one broke the tie a moment ago, a high snap, but not that high, John.
It's one of those things a punter has to prepare himself to think about. He didn't know whether to pick it up or kick it. By the time he made the decision, the Seminoles were all over him. He couldn't make the
81 Orange Bowl after this.
See who gets down here. Oklahoma scores the last part of the ball game easily.
J.C. Watts has got plenty left on a first. Best matchup of all the bowl games is turning out to be that. Now the Sooners trying to tie the game and get in the end zone.
Any more than their average. They just haven't moved it as consistently.
First and 10. Straight ahead, and look at this run by Florida State's Mike. I'd want to be in Miami too if I was from Nenana, Alaska. Got a group up down here from there. Gotta be rough in Nenana, New Year's Day.
Rending defensive line.
And then Superior. Stockstill has a problem. Keith Gary's running him down. That big guy can motor.
They didn't get there. I think Georgia came into this ball game number one. It's close. Florida State has impressed me something I didn't expect to see, really.
Watts throws. Steve Rhodes catches the ball. It's a foot race. Rhodes has the hamstring pull. He'll have a problem, but he does get down to the third.
All of a sudden, you know he walked up to Barry Switzer and said, Coach, let me have a go at it. I'm not saving my leg for anything special. This means a little bit to all of us. He went in, not only ran a fine pattern, but took the ball.
Oklahoma Sooners are down by seven, 17-10. 2:10 left to play. Watts throws, man is open. He's got Chet Winters. Overtime in college football, but there is the option for the two-point conversion. You know if Oklahoma gets in, they'll be doing that. It's intercepted and lost. Could have had an interception.
Well, those balls look so easy to catch, but you take a defensive tackle who's involved in the totality of the ball game, you think he could put it away, but he's wearing great big old gloves. That ball.
1:48 to go at second down and 10 for the Sooners. Watts in the rollout, stands in, eludes the rush. J.C. Watts has a channel. He gets a great block, and Watts is out of bounds. To play now. What a game.
Just a man like J.C. Watts can make that play happen. Defensively, the play had no chance. Watts got out.
Coaches get old. This does the aging. There's a throw. Oh, man, it was almost an interception.
Would have topped off one of the finest performances that I've seen in the Orange Bowl from what is considered to be a steady, everyday, do-your-job. Really outstanding. He's been in the right spot all night long, and he came up with a
second down and 10. Here's J.C. Watts with the throw, and a man has the ball in the end zone for a touchdown. Steve Rhodes gets it. He came back.
They caught the Seminoles in a little bit of a mix-up defensively. They were caught right at the snap of the ball. They fast huddled them. They got up. Rhodes ran a fine pattern. J.C. a lot on the ball. He had to take enough off because you see Bobby Butler's in a pretty good position. He's got to leave it out.
They are going for two. 1:27 to go. The football game could be on the line with this play. J.C. rolls out. Man is open. Oklahoma takes the lead as he hits for us below. Here it is. J.C. Watts rolls out, lofts it high over the defense, and Flores Flora comes down with the ball. He's made some big, big plays for Oklahoma. He makes one every time he tries to block because he's one of the best blockers in football.
Don't think that being a good block.
So the Sooners, 1:52 is all the time it took. And 1:27 is all.